Hello, and welcome to this video on Webform A/B testing. Webform A/B testing in Zoho CRM is used to experiment with your web forms and identify the best performing ones. You can A/B test your web forms with different fields, CTAs, and also different color combinations. You can test the web form for a selected time frame of your choice and also choose the percentage of the audience to whom the new version should be visible. Upon A/B testing, you can determine which form performs better and deploy that form across your website. Let's consider Zilker Tech, a product-based company. Across their web page, they have different web forms. They want to understand and improve the conversion rate for all of their forms. Let's see how Zilker's most important form, the registration form, has been performing. Based on the analytics here, we can see that partial submissions of the form are much higher than completed submissions. When we analyze the field's filled rate, we can see that the field's phone, industry, and employee count are lower compared to the field's filled rate of name, email, and company. Now, Zilker can probably get a better conversion rate if they removed the phone, industry, and employee count fields altogether. But to know this information would help Zilker deepen customer interactions. So, another possibility can be by removing the industry and employee count fields and making the phone number field mandatory. But instead of taking a call on modifying a web form without any information, we can create two variants of the original web forms with both possibilities and open it up for only a selected set of audience and for a selected period of time. Once the A/B test is completed, we can analyze the conversion rate and launch the web form that performs better across your website. Let's see how we can do this in Zoho CRM. Go to Setup, Developer Space, Web Forms. Click on the ellipses here near the registration form, and you can create A/B test from there or by clicking the Create A/B Test button here. Enter their name for the A/B test. Here, you can see that a variant of the original form is created. We can edit the properties of the existing fields by clicking on the settings icon after each field. We can change the background of the form from here, modify the CTA again by changing the settings, change the alignment of the form from here, and set the form width from here. In this first variant, let's delete the fields phone, industry, and employee count. Here, on top, click the plus icon to create another variant. In this variant, let's remove the fields industry and employee count. And the field settings for the phone number field, let's select as mark as required field and save it. In the field properties, you can also mark a field as hidden or add a hint message for the field. Apart from that, we have the link to view changes made to the variant by clicking on View Changes List. Any change that is done to the variant will be captured here, and you will also have a revert option to revert back the changes. Once we modify the variants, we move on to the next step, which is the A/B testing configuration. Here, we can configure the time, audience, and criteria for the A/B testing to happen. As a first step, you can select the percentage of your website visitors who are to be included in the A/B testing environment. You can select 100% if you want all of the visitors in your testing environment. If not, you can select a percentage of the audience that you think is the most appropriate and safe for testing. For Zilker's example, let's select 70%. You can see how the visitors will be split among your visitors here. You can modify the way that you deem fit. Let's show Zilker's original form to 30% of the audience, the first variant to 20% of the audience, and the second variant to 20% of the audience. Now, the next step is to determine when you want the test to end. You can choose to end it after a select number of days, weeks, or months. You can also choose a date range during which the testing will be active. If not, you can choose to end the A/B test after a specific number of visitors are targeted. For Zilker, let's choose after 30 days. You can opt to receive an email notification about the winner by checking this box. You can also choose to launch the winner once the testing is complete. This will automatically launch the web form that has the highest conversion rate across your website. Upon checking this, you can see that you can provide a condition to launch the successful form only when the conversion rate of the winner is however much percentage higher than the runner form. Let's enter 50%. Note that if you choose to end the testing after a certain set of visitors, then the A/B test will be automatically moved to completed after 3 months, even if the visitor count was not reached in the testing limit. The form which has the highest conversion rate will be the winner, and when launched, the variant form that wins will become the original form. Let's begin the A/B testing. After 30 days, you can see the analytics of the test form from here. The A/B testing stats shows unique submissions and visitors for the original and variant forms, the conversion rate, and the improvement rate, which shows how much the variant has improved over the original form. The percentage of visitors is also shown here. Comparison by conversion chart shows the analytics for each day. You can see the conversion rate on a select day and the unique submissions and number of visitors, same with the improvement rate chart. It shows how the variant has improved each day over the original with the improvement rate and the unique submissions per visitor. You can also get the analytics based on the field filled rate, number of submissions that has filled each field, and the percentage of submissions that has filled each field. All of this will help in arriving at what kind of web form works best with the audience. You can launch the winner of the A/B test across your website from the Launch button here. Open the form, and you can preview how the form will look for visitors. Under the variants, you can also see all of the changes made. Note that Webform A/B testing will only work for forms which are hosted in iframe or embed format in your websites. You can delete a Webform A/B test from here. That's all about Webform A/B testing. Thank you for watching this video. For more resources on Zoho CRM, please visit www.zoho.com/crm/resources.